right now at Boko, this area is called Lobona Junction, located between Boko and Yabe.
Before the advent of the Governor Samuel Ortom's administration, this road became impassable. The portal on the road simply became a set of deep potholes.
Sarawa kentite yoseva ile pemu ke Yesu kentite yoseva ile pemu.
The project of
Jasha Kushaku Jayamba Kristu Jayamba Kristu ni akushakele kashere.
What has happened? The drainages have been constructed. We are
erosion.
Thank you.
Awambo, awambe Abraham, ya etele ka Thank you. nasueno.
I as you can see, all the bridges.
Some of our brothers discovered that Chief Isaac Shahu's road has been under construction. So we have driven on the road from Inca roundabout down to your house. So we said, okay, it's good, let's find out if the Honorable Minister is still around so that he may say a word or two about this development. And then give us an advice. Give Nigerians a word of advice. Because Nigeria is going through some turbulent situations. So, Honorable Minister. Scrutinizing the cars. Yes, sir. I thought that. Yes, sir. I thought that, yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Thank you, sir.
We are glad that you have permitted us to come where you are and have a chat with you. This chat is very historical because we have not seen you for a long time. We have not heard from you for a long time. You are one of the forefathers of Nigeria. You were in politics before independence, and you have been in politics all this while. So, talking with you, we elicit a lot of information that will help the current generation understand Nigeria. But we begin with the renovation of streets, especially the Chief Isaac Shaho Road.
What do you want to say about this? Because, you see, I'm very careful when people want to interview me. First of all, they give me time. So that if there's any thing that I have forgotten, hold it. Maybe I say, come back again. And I look through my papers. Maybe I'll do it. But now you're just visiting, not me. That's all. I guess on General
coverage.
Well, for that reason, I will not say much. But you asked me one thing. Oh, and then you added a second one.
Yes, sir.
What is Nigeria doing? Right?
The first one is?
No, the second one.
Okay, the second one. The second one is your words.
You, the younger generation, have put us there.
We are.
Have put us there, where we are today.
Yes, sir.
Instead of going forward, we are coming backwards. All you want, I want position, and out of this position, make money for myself and for my family. That's all. But we were more forward looking. The Benue people and the Tigray in particular were very, very straightforward.
Yes.
Because if you saw anybody stealing, it was a team. He will not have even to go and get married. They know him. He's a writer. He's a writer. But today, you get into a position instead of developing your position or your community, you go stealing and the rest of it, making the community poorer and poorer and poorer.
Yes.
So the first question has almost three or the second one. Or your generation. What are we going to do about it? We keep on talking. Some of us, as strong as we are, like, you come, we'll tell you the truth.
Yes.
You will not beat me. If you beat me, the police as well, or the authorities there. So we keep on telling you, Maybe someday you'll be ashamed and change yourself. You're ashamed and change yourself. Well, what was the second, the first one?
Yeah, well, you will tell us much more about the country from colonialism to the present generation, wow. The present republic. What you think about it? What advice you have for us in this generation?
The advice is the one I'm giving you.
Yes.
You must change your attitude.
Yes.
That's the truth. Well, we learned from the colonial administration. And while we wanted to become independent, they fought for it. Not physically as in other places, but somehow, by royal grace, it came. As if it were on a platter of the 1960. Well, I hadn't joined the party worker or politicians then. However, what is happening, or what advice I give, is the one I say, change your attitude. Not for yourself. To get leadership is for your community.
Yes.
To get leadership, it is for your country. I'm talking not only about you, but Nigeria in general.
Yes.
Well, that is my general advice.
Yes,
I think that is all right because it is not giving me time. You just jumped me. And I was outside in the
best you said.
Well, I think I wait until you. But I thank the God very much. He came, he made me just like this. He came from this side too. The
yes.
So why he came is talking. And said, oh, was it? This good and what? With another road. I said, well, the road has been named Shah.
Yes, yes.
But there are two Shahus. Shahu the father and Shahu me the son.
Yes.
The late Shahu, who is my father, was Joseph Shahu.
Yes.
I am Isaac Shahu. So, help me to solve this, Mr. Governor. Because I don't be fighting with my father over a street. A street name. Was the dear shareholder, that's all right.
Yes.
That is why he increased the Isaac. I said, all right, you have solved me a problem. Because my old man, the guy, will be asking, is the boy trying to fight with me over property? So he helped me solve that problem.
So what is the name of the road now?
Isaac
Shah.
Yes.
Okay, sir. That's great, sir. So how do you feel about the road, the reconstruction of the road?
Well, it's a development for the community.
Yes, sir.
Not something that I put in my pocket. But once it is finished, maybe it will take plenty of this traffic off from the front.
Yes,
sir. Sometimes I sit here, I look at the petrol station. All people try to go over as well, especially gold mines. That's what you do. But the road is there to be used. There's nothing we can do about it. We are the other people who should take precautions, precautionary measures to see how we cross it. Has been solved for me by the Lord.
Yes. We are grateful, sir.
Thank you.
The last question we'll play that you comment on is the problem that farmers have with herdsmen. Problem of farmers with herdsmen in Thiefland and in other parts of the country. What can you say, what will you say about this crisis?
Well, Here too, I just follow the governor's introduction of righteous. Because if we were able to do it, there would be no problem. In other countries, civilized countries, the West, say Europe or so on, they had some problem, especially in America, North America. Yes. But they were able to solve it back. There were plenty of land. And anybody would go into a state, file his papers, then put a claim to a piece of land. There it became a ranch. Well, your cattle will now go into the ranch of another person or into the land of another person. If they did, something will happen. Maybe somebody will lose his life or somebody will lose their lives. People will lose their lives as well. So I think the father had said it's a very serious thing. Here too, in our own context, the whole days, anybody who had looking in this house, he used to bring them to one round place. The children will go in the morning and bring them back. So I think that is the only thing. Yes.
Thank you very much. Yes. God bless you.
You too.
We are grateful that you have granted us this interview. We are also thankful to God for Him to enable us to see you. And we also pray that may God increase your time on earth. We wish you long life. We wish you divine health, prosperity, and laughter. In Jesus' name. Amen. God has already answered. You're already laughing. So the laughter has come. And that is clear that more laughter is going to come your way in a short while from now.
Okay.
Thanks a lot, sir.
Okay.
So we'll be on our way. God bless you, sir.
The other White House, this road too was condemned. It was Shimayu, the red cross, the new
When we were one being yellow, it's a yama one being.